Hi guys, I thought I'd share a quick little video with you. I am going to buy the Ultimate Edition. I'm going to save myself £25. It's going to cost me about £5 more than it would cost to buy the Standard Edition as a pre-order. So I thought I'd share this video just in case people didn't know and run through what the additional benefits are to having the Ultimate Edition and then show you quickly how to get hold of this and save yourself £25, which is pretty much a third off. Great benefit to keep it in your pocket. Do what you want with it. Save it. Buy FIFA points. Join our Discord for 2 months. You know, there's so many different things you can do with that money, but it's better in your pocket than giving it to EA. So, some of the additional benefits that you get, if you order before the 11th of August, which is tomorrow, you will get a Foot Heroes card. The only thing is, you will not get this until the 1st of December. So for me, it's not a massive pull to be getting the Ultimate Edition. It's not a massive benefit because by that time, this card probably will be behind the meta. On top of that, though, you are getting a Ones to Watch player item, which could be massive. Imagine packing a Ones to Watch Messi. That could be actually game-changing. You also get 4 days early access, so rather than waiting till the 1st of October, you get to start playing the game on the 27th of September. So that's massive. Anyone who likes trading wants to get ahead of the pack. This is a massive benefit, and for me, it's one of the main pulls of buying this. The other main thing is if you're playing on an old gen console, having the dual entitlement is a must because if you have a PS4 and you want to buy a PS5, you will have to buy another copy, which means you'll be spending another 59 to 60 odd pounds on an upgrade for the same game, just a little bit better. You'll also get 4,600 FIFA points, which is replacing these packs that we used to get that, to be honest, gave you literally nothing. So there's two websites that I would advise using. One is CD Keys. So the best way of doing this is to buy two £35 network cards. The reason being is because once you've saved the discounts, it's going to cost you £72.89. So what we're going to do is we're going to get the £70 and make the £2.89 up from your debit card or your preferred payment method. CD Keys currently cost around £30.99. Shopto, do not buy this one because this is not a digital card. Buy the digital card version, which is currently costing £30.23, which basically saves you £10. Saving at the moment £9.77 off of this, which is insane. What you'll do is you'll buy two of these cards, you'll go in, once that's done, it'll come up telling you go to your account. And you'll view the details and you'll get these codes. Once you have these codes, you will then switch over to the PS4. Once you're on the PS4, you will run into the PlayStation Store. You'll go to More and then you'll redeem your codes. This will then give you a wallet balance of £70. Once you've completed that, you'll be logging into FIFA 21. The logic behind this is because you'll now get another 20% off of the £89.99. So if you buy this from the main menu in the PlayStation Store, it will still cost you £80.99. If you go into Ultimate Team, you'll go down to the bottom here, go across to pre-order FIFA 22. Once it's loaded up, you'll have the choice between the two. As I said, we've covered this off. So you'll still get the loan item for Kylian Mbappe. You'll still get the untradeable Team of the Week player. You'll get an Ambassador Loan player pick, which is a high-rated card that will be another loan card. You'll also get the opportunity to get a Career Mode Homegrown Talent player, which is another benefit. So for me, I want a copy of the Ultimate because of the benefits. As I said, getting the 4 days in advance is good. So you'll have a choice, as I said, of paying £80.99. This would be the price you play on the PlayStation Store. With EA Play, but because we've gone through FIFA 21, you will have the choice of the two. So EA Play will cost you £4. If you are on if you're on Xbox, you can actually go on to Shopto and CD Keys, and I believe they actually do it for £2.99. You can actually buy it. So I would obviously say it's worth paying the £3.99 because you're actually saving £4 on top of that. If you do actually want any FIFA points as well, this will give you 10% off any in-purchase for the FIFA points. So that's another benefit for yourselves. So that's kind of the benefits to that. So I would do this. I'm going to accept that. I'm going to buy that. Order and pay. So I've already got the £70. And they've got the £2.89 on top. And I've also got the EA Play. So that's going to cost me £3.99. Really simple and easy video. I've left the links underneath. Please use them. It just benefits and supports us. So please use that. And that is a way of saving yourself pretty much £25. If this has helped you, if you didn't know about this, please leave a like. Please leave a comment. Let me know if it's helped you. And thank you for watching.